Dear students, welcome to zoology class. Let us discuss about the levels and hierarchy of classification. It is impossible to study of all living organisms. So, it is possible to study of living organisms when they are divided into categories. So this process is called classification. Classification means the living organisms are divided into categories. The process is called classification. So zoos and museums are tools for the classification of organisms. Zoos are the places where animals are taken out from their natural habitat and product under the human care. Zoos are the places where the animals are taken out from their natural habitat and product under the human care are called zoos. So here we can observe the external characters of animals and their behavior. So museums have biological specimens, models and skeletons. Biological specimens are the preservative animals which preserved in containers or jars in preservative solution. It includes dry specimens also, like insects are preserved in the boxes. So in this process, these organisms are collected, killing and pinning to the sheet and preserved in the insect box. Museums also have some skeletons which organisms are died. So let us discuss about the hierarchy of classification. Carolus Linnaeus was a French scientist. He was called as father of taxonomy and founder of modern systematics. Carolus Linnaeus, called as father of taxonomy and founder of modern systematics. So he established the classification category is taxa. It is the plural word. Taxon is the singular word of the category of organisms. So Linnaeus introduced categories such as kingdom, class, order, genus and species. Haeckel was another scientist. He introduced the category phylum. Actually, living organisms are divided into three domains. Domains are the higher categories of classification. So here, bacteria, archaea, eukarya are the three domains which are present in the animal classification. So, the classification consists of taxonomy. Already we know that the taxonomy is the study of identification, nomenclature and classification of organisms. So, here the classification includes taxonomy. So there are seven obligatory characters are present in the taxonomy. So those are kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species and subspecies are the seven obligatory characters. So actually organisms are classified into five kingdoms by R.H. Whittaker. Those are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. These are the five kingdoms which are classified by the R.H. Whittaker. So, nowadays, Monera divided into two separate kingdoms. Those are Bacteria and Archaea. Bacteria and Archaea. Hence, there are six kingdoms are present in the classification of organisms. So, now discuss about the seven obligatory characters. So, here, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species and subspecies are the seven obligatory characters which are present in the living organisms classification. So, kingdom is the higher category of classification. So, here, multicellular and heterotroph, all living organisms are included in the kingdom. Multicellular and all heterotrophs living organisms are included in the category of kingdom. For example, Animalia. Animalia is a kingdom. So, which includes number of phyla, phylum. Phyla is the plural word. Phylum is a singular word. So, phylum includes one or more classes. So, here, for example, Chordata includes Cyclostomata, Chondrichthys, Osteichthys, Amphibia, Reptilia, Mammalia. So, these are the different types of classes. So, these are all classes are included in the phylum of Chordata. So, these are included in the Chordata based on the presence of notochord, hallo, dorsal, navicord, pharyngeal gill slits, ventral, heart and post-anal tail. So, these classes are included in the phylum Chordata based on the presence of notochord, hallo, dorsal, navicord, ventral heart, post-anal tail and pharyngeal gill slits. So, these features are consist in the life of history of these organisms. So, all these classes are included in the phylum Chordata. Next one, class. So, here one or more orders are included in a category is called class. Hence, here class include one or more orders. For example, Mammalia is a class. Already we know that here. Mammalia is a class. It includes Rodentia, Chiroptera, Cetacea, Carnivora, Primates. These are the orders. So, Rodentia includes rats. Chiroptera includes bats. Cetacea includes whales. Carnivora includes dogs, fox, wolves, etc. Primates includes monkeys, gibbons, gorilla and human beings. Next one, order. So, here it is includes one or more families. Order includes one or more families. So, here for example, Carnivora is a order. So, it includes Felidae and Canidae. Felidae, Canidae are the families. Felidae, Canidae are the families which are included in the order of Carnivora. Next one, family. Family includes one or more genera. For example, Felidae is a family. It includes two genera, those are Felis and Panthera. If we add the suffix -idae to the genus, or genera, it will be converted into family. If we add suffix -ide to the genus or genera, it will be converted into the family. If we add suffix -ine to the genus or genera, it will be converted into subfamily. If we add suffix -oide to the genus or genera, it will be converted into superfamily. If we take an example, for example, Homo is a genus. Homo is a genus. So Homo sapiens is the scientific name of human being. So here, Homo nidae. If we add suffix -ide to the genus Homo, it will be converted into family, that is called Homonidae. If we add suffix to the -ine to the Homo, it will be converted into subfamily as Homoniniae. If we add suffix to the Homoidae, it will be converted into superfamily as Homoniniae. Homoniae, Homonidae, Homoniniae, Homoniidae. These are the family, subfamily, superfamily of Homo sapiens. Next one, genus. Genus is a group of related species. Genus includes a group of related species. For example, Panthera is the genus. Panthera is the genus. It includes Panthera leo, Panthera tigris, Panthera podrus. Panthera is a genus. It includes species like Panthera leo, Panthera tigris, Panthera podrus. Panthera leo is the scientific name of lion. Panthera tigris is the scientific name of tiger. Panthera podrus is the scientific name of leopard. So these are all species are included in the genus Panthera. Next one, species. Species is the basic unit of classification. Species is the basic unit of classification. So it includes similar organisms. It includes similar organisms which sharing common gene pool and freely interbreeding and produce offspring. Species are the similar group of organisms which are sharing common gene pool and freely interbreeding, produce offspring is called species. So here, sometimes species also include subspecies. So subspecies are the geographical isolated animals. Geographical isolated animals. For example, if we take an example, crow. The scientific name of crow is Corvus splendens. Corvus splendens. So here, India and Pakistan, crows are Corvus splendens, splendens. Corvus splendens. Subspecies is splendens again. So here, Corvus is genus, splendens is species, subspecies is splendens. Corvus splendens, splendens is the scientific name of crow which is present in the India and Pakistan. So Corvus splendens insolens is the scientific name of crow which is present in the Myanmar. Corvus splendens insolens is the scientific name of crow which is present in the Myanmar. Corvus splendens protegatus is the scientific name of crow which is present in the Sri Lanka. So these are the seven obligatory characters which are involved in the living organisms classification or animal classification.